part of the issue that is at play in America today, and we've all been traveling around the country, I certainly have, I'm meeting people who are working 2 and 3 jobs. You know, this president walks around talking about and flouting his great economy, right? My great economy, my great economy. You ask him, well, how are you measuring this greatness of this economy of yours? And he talks about the stock market. Well, that's fine if you own stocks. So many families in America do not. You ask them, how are you measuring the greatness of this economy of yours? And they point to the jobless numbers and the unemployment numbers. Well, yeah, people in America are working. They're working 2 and 3 jobs. So when we talk about jobs, let's be really clear. In our America, no one should have to work more than one job to have a roof over their head and food on the table.
Thank you very much.
A few moments later.
Kamala Harris promises opportunities, but outsources U.S. jobs to Indian graduates. By Neil Monroe on June 30, 2019. Senator Kamala Harris is declaring herself the supporter of working families, but she is the lead Democratic sponsor on legislation which offers green cards to hundreds of thousands of Indian college grads who agree to take middle-class jobs sought by young American graduates. If Harris' outsourcing law is adopted, the rush of Central Americans migrants at the southern border will be overshadowed by a huge rush of Indian college graduates walking into professional jobs throughout the United States. It is impossible to understate the significance of this, said Jessica Vaughn, policy director at the Center for Immigration Studies. Vaughn continued, a lot of people believe this is only for IT professionals, but the potential impact goes way beyond IT, healthcare, accountants, and other professional jobs will be at risk. These are jobs which offered a gateway into the middle class for kids from families where the parents did not have white-collar jobs. American graduates are going to see their employment prospects severely restricted by Harris bill. This is white C0-ler labor trafficking, she added. Working families need support and need to be lifted up, Kamala Harris told the TV audience at the June 28th Democrat debate, adding, frankly, this economy is not working for working people. For too long, the rules have been written in the favor of the people who have the most and not in favor of the people who work the most. We have all been traveling around the country. I certainly have. I'm meeting people who are working 2 and 3 jobs. So when we talk about jobs, let's be really clear. In our America, no one should have to work more than one job to have a roof over their head and food on the table. Harris is the lead Democratic sponsor for the Fairness for High-Skilled Immigrants Act. The legislation is intended to help Indian graduates get roughly 120,000 green cards each year, or roughly 5 times as many green cards as they receive now.
Do you support reparations for Black people?
Well, listen, no.
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 Let's really be clear about that. So I'm not going to sit here and say I'm going to do something that's only going to benefit Black people.
But Harris bill is a special interest fix for a problem collectively created by the federal government, India's government, CEOs, investors, and their hired foreign contract workers. The huge career and financial cost of Harris fix will be imposed on young American graduates, including millions of U.S. graduates who are likely to vote Democratic in 2020. The problem. Companies can nominate as many foreign workers as they wish, even though the federal government only provides 140,000 cards for foreign college graduates each year. So, of course, there is a growing backlog in the green card line as companies nominate more people than there are green cards. Only some categories of foreign workers are eligible for these green cards. The most important group is the Army of the Foreign Contract Workers and H-1B Work Visa Program. Workers with H-1B visas have to go home after 6 years of work, unless they get nominated by their company for one of the 140,000 green cards. Once nominated, the H-1B workers continue working for the same employer until they get their green card, after which they can try to find jobs with better pay and conditions. So companies have a huge financial incentive to hire and import cheap foreign workers on temporary visas, and to then nominate many of the temporary workers for green cards once their temporary status is about to expire. Already, companies employ roughly 1 million foreign contract workers via the H-1B program. That hidden subsidy to U.S. business means at least 1 million college graduate jobs are closed to American graduates. It also means that most Americans' graduates are earning lower salaries because companies do not have to compete for their skills. Instead, Americans' graduates have to compete hard for jobs that pay more than the wages earned by baristas, waiters, and temps. Indian graduates. Almost 70% of incoming H-1B workers are Indian because the Indian government has used the program as an economic development policy. That government policy has been extremely successful, and Indian firms have won subcontracts worth billions from American investors who want to boost their stock values by outsourcing many of their operations to cheap Indian subcontractors. Roughly 1 million Indian foreign graduates have cycled through the H-1B program. While in the United States, the H-1B workers work closely with teams of India-based workers to boost the Indian economy with a huge variety of outsourced work, including software design, database maintenance, health records management, banking networks, customer support services, and even the development of avionics software for Boeing aircraft. Most of these workers return home, bringing with them the skills, connections, and contracts that have created a national technology boom and a new middle class. About 71% of tech employees in the Valley are foreign-born, compared to around 50% in the San Francisco-Oakland-Hayward region, according to a new report based on 2016 census data. The paper's research indicated that 63% of Seattle's foreign-born tech workers were not American citizens.
Do you support reparations for Black people?
Well, listen, no.
No, no.
Let's really be clear about that. So I'm not gonna sit here and say I'm gonna do something that's only gonna benefit Black people.
How do you share this happiness right now?
I'm very happy. I mean, naturally, I'm very happy to be, you know, it's my sister's daughter, like my daughter she is, so it's very happy about it.
Basically, a woman from Tamil diaspora who's making such a huge success in the U.S.
No, it's all credit goes to my sister. My sister, her mother, went to U.S. in 1958. And she's lived there, and she's a very strong lady, and she brought her children up very well. So if Kamala has, whatever Kamala is today, the credit goes to my sister and no one else.
Whatever Kamala is today, the credit goes to my sister and no one else.
Whatever Kamala is today, the credit goes to my sister and no one else.
What was the initial thoughts about, I mean, the campaign of Kamala? How was the trend which was in the U.S.?
I think she knew how to do it. She knows how to win people. So I have no doubt about it. She's quite charming and she knows how to win people.